So yeah, Rory, this is obviously a massive piece of news, but it's come from kind of nowhere for a lot of people. What's it been like for you, and how has the process even started in the first place that you're going to America to take part in the Commonwealth?
Unbelievable opportunity. An opportunity to probably never thought would ever come because, like, Irish people in the NFL, you know, there's not massive amount. There has been out there is Dan Whelan at the moment, but for that opportunity to come around, when I got actually got the call or got the text about 5 months ago from Tadhg Leader to say that this opportunity was coming, if he wanted to give it a go. So he said, why not? I'll try my best, and went up and met him, and there's a couple of other people there, and just gave it a go and felt good at it. Felt like this is something that I could get better at and better at, and with a bit of coaching from Tag and stuff, it's eventually has got me to this point. And the next point now is the training camp, and then move into hopefully do well at the combine, and we never know what'll happen after that.
Were you a fan of the sport going into it, or did Tadhg take you by surprise when you got the text?
I would have watched it. I wouldn't say I would sit up and watch the games. I'd watch the Red Zone on a Sunday. What bits of it, you know, would have known Pat Murray would have played over his time over there at the stage, and I would have gained a lot of interest then. But gained a lot more interest in the last year. And since obviously Metallic came along and gave me the text, it's just sort of garnered my interest even more and more. Probably watching it a lot more than I would soccer now. Usually I'd sit back and watch the soccer a lot, but NFL is starting to take away a bit more of an interest now, and it's cool. Like, it's just it's a cool opportunity to know that this you could potentially be there in a year's time. Like,
How difficult of a decision has it to be to keep going with this process, especially after the year that you've just had? Obviously, the All-Ireland semi, that cracking semi or penalty shootout that you had in Croke Park. Is it that you reached a level that you're happy with the county that you can take this break, or was it something that you really had to think long and hard about?
I definitely had to think long and hard about it. Like, Gaelic football has been a part of my life since 6 years of age, and then like my father played, and you know, as I said, I'm a massive GA fan as well as a player. Like, I'd watch a lot of the Gaelic football. I'd go to a lot of games that I'm not involved in. So to make that decision was tough. It was tough. Like, all your friends are at home playing the sport. It's a big part of the community where I live and stuff. But when an opportunity like this came around, it's not something that you can just put away and hope for to come again. Like, that's not an option. For me, it's giving it everything I have now, and hoping that it will work out. But yeah, it was an incredibly tough decision. But it's a decision I made, and I want to give it a crack at it. As I said, there's no guarantees in the sport, but I'll give it everything I have anyway, and hopefully something will come out of it.
Who were the ones that you trusted with the decision, like your friends and family? Was there certain ones in particular you went to that said yes or no to it?
Mostly family, father, my mother, and one or two friends who would be NFL fans as well, but also footballers. Just had to chat with them and said, look, this is an opportunity you can't really pass by. And they're right. Like, you know, it's something that I didn't want to spread too much, and I wanted just the right people to know, and people who had opinion out respect as well. And look, they were all in favor and all happy for it to happen, and said this is an opportunity you can't really pass. So here I am, decisions been made, people have been consulted. So great news.
It must feel massive for you individually because obviously you're high profile and what this will do now when the announcement happens. And it's that you guys are instrumental. You're the first wave of hopefully plenty of Irish lads breaking in to the NFL. There must be a massive level of excitement and pride that you're like a flag bearer.
It is, and that's something I thought about. You know, when Tadhg was telling us this is the first year of the Kickers, that they went toward Ireland with four, I think four Irish coming over. Like, it's just cool that we could potentially create that pathway for more and more. And the GA will not be happy with it because they're probably potentially be losing a lot of their big players. But when you realize the opportunity is ahead of you, it's not something chipped off. Like it's something that I think everyone should think long and hard about if it becomes an option for them. Like there's a lot of very talented kickers of a dead ball in Ireland and England as well. So it's cool to know that you're potentially starting a pathway now for hopefully a lot more Irish into the NFL.
And obviously, like, you'd be renowned for your kicking in the country. How was it to transition into obviously the oval shaped ball? Did you find it difficult? Was there some tweaks that you found frustrating to get used to in that?
Yeah, at the start, there was a tough transition, first week or two. But in fairness to Tadhg, he done a lot of work with me, a few one-to-one sessions as well, bit of video analysis and stuff like that. But I think the biggest transition or the biggest challenge was to follow through. But the way I sort of strike a Gaelic football would be more towards just sort of drilling the ball nearly and not with much of a follow-through. Whereas here now, transitioning to get the leg up and to get the height on it. And obviously, a lot of my kicking will be based off 1, 2, 3 steps anyway. So for for field goals and the 1.3 seconds, obviously, to get to the ball is natural enough in terms of my run-up anyway. It's just the follow-through, your body position and coming through the ball. That's the biggest transition. But we've worked hard. I've worked hard at it the last 5, 6 months. So starting this bear fruits of it now, and hopefully that will set me up nicely for the next few weeks, months.
You've obviously talked about the hard work that's been put in the last few months. Like, you must be buzzing to get over to America and go to the combine and just show off, really, and be one of the best there. Like, you're not going just to, you know, make up numbers. You must really want to show off now at this point.
I do, yeah, and I wouldn't have made that decision to do this if it wasn't going in full throttle. As I said, how difficult it was to leave the Monaghan squad and leave the Scotstown and behind. It wasn't an easy decision, so I'm not gonna, go over here and not give it everything I have. I'm looking forward to just getting over there to the training with the lads and literally train like a professional athlete and see the improvements that can be made. With a lot more contact time with coaches and stuff, and then hopefully go to the combine, just mindset that I'm going to be the best here. That's the way it has to be. It's the way I approach Gaelic football, and it's the way I'm going to approach this.
And as kind of when you're talking there, was stepping away from Monaghan, is that just giving you massive fuel that you're saying, look, I've given up a lot here? Does that make the training so much easier and then the kick so much further or higher, whatever it is, that you're just putting everything in because you have a lot of fuel there because of those decisions?
Yeah, 100%. You nailed it right there. Like, there's a lot I have to prove as well over here. But, I've been with Monaghan since 2011 and started competitively since 2013. So to just put that to the side, to go over here, there's a lot of people to it. Yeah, there's a lot of motivation to succeed here. And that's what I want to do. And that's what I aim to do. I'm not going over here for handy raids. You know?
And in terms of, obviously, you'd be going over for the sport, but part of the decision has to be that you could end up anywhere in America. Would you miss the likes of Lipton's and Clonus if you have to move over? Are you ready for the American lifestyle if it was to work out in your favour?
Yeah, 100%. Like, I've been in America a few times, obviously, on holidays and stuff. And it's a brilliant, lovely country. Like, like, not that I've been at every part of it, but it'd be nice to get over and experience it in terms of living it as a career as well. It'd be really nice to do that there. As you said, yeah, Lipton's and McMahon's and all the places, and you'll miss them surely. And obviously, as I said, big part of your life. But in terms of trying this out, yeah, something I'm looking forward to trying out too.
And I'll leave you with this. What in the terms of this process now, especially when it comes to the combine and hopefully hooking up with a team, what is the minimum level of success you want from this now over the next couple of months?
Just to be recognised as, firstly, I want to get signed. That's the big aim. That's everybody's aim here. But I don't want to go over there and just, live two or three years in the practice roster, not make it a good jump out. I was like, I want to be in the top 32 kickers in order. Like, that's why I'm going here. I want to succeed. I want to be the best. I'm not going to wear the settle for second best. I know I'll have to do my time and I'll have to work really, really hard to get there. But that's why you're here, I suppose, isn't it?
One more I have to leave you with. We heard you were in Dungannon now at the end of this month with Pro Football Ireland. You're going to come along to that, aren't you?
I'm down for it, yeah, at the minute, yeah. So,
yeah, good to hear. Good to hear. Thanks so much for your time. All right, best of luck.
No problem. Thank you.